Okay, a quick one to explain the difference between the evaluation order when using the different increment and decrement operator. So you all know the classical for loop where you set I to 0, set until I is less than something, and then you do I plus plus. And let's say here, for example, I just print the value of I. But there is also another increment operator, which is plus plus I. And you can see that if I run it here, it's exactly the same behavior. But why is there a different notation? The reason is that the result of this operation will be evaluated before. So I think I have an example to make it clearer. So let's say I want an array of integers. So let's just do five of them. And let's say that for some reason, I want to iterate with a while loop this time. And I want to do I until I is less than. Or let's just say that maybe I want to set a minus one at the end and I want to iterate while x I is different than minus one. And so in this case, you could do to reproduce kind of the for loop behavior. You would say x is equal to x is I, like so, and then you would say print percentage d, and then x, and at the end, of course, you would say I plus plus. So that's basically the for loop, but in a while loop. So you get the same behavior. But now, what you can do is in the element access thing, when we access the element of x, we can actually increment here. So we could increment I here instead. And you can see that it's still the same result. So it first uses the value, the current value of I, then it increments it and puts it back into I. So it evaluates the array access first. But now if you put plus plus I instead, you're gonna see that it's gonna change a little. Now we first get 2 and then we get the minus 1 at the end. So that means that it first incremented I, then did the array, then it did the it did look up the element at that array index after the increment, not before. And so yeah, that's pretty much the difference between I plus plus and plus plus I. And yeah, that's pretty much it. This also works with the decrement operator, of course. I mean, in this case, it wouldn't work, but there is a minus minus I or I minus minus. And that's also why in C++, when you have an iterator, so for auto it is equal to something while it is different than something and, then you could do it plus plus. But oftentimes you see people do plus plus iterator, and that's because if you do the prefix notation of the increment operator, it doesn't have to create a copy of the value. So when you do like the minus minus at the end or the plus plus at the end, it has to create a copy of the value first, then increment, and then use the copy to access the array element. And same thing here. And so, yeah, usually it's better. I think the compiler can probably optimize that away for simple ints, but for like complex iterators in C++, it would be a bit trickier. And so that's why people use the prefix notation instead of the suffix. So yeah, that's it. That's how that's the difference between I++ versus plus plus I. And yeah, hope this cleared some things up. See you.